Hello friends, today's our topic is Knerr's repertory. His repertory classified under Puritan group of repertory or non-philosophical repertory, which is based on Herring's guiding symptom of our materia medica and which was compiled by Dr. Kelvin B. Knerr. So today we are going to discuss about some basic features from theoretical part and also some features from practical part which are useful in clinical practice. This is the front page of repertory. Dr. Kelvin B. Knerr had assisted some 7 volumes of Herring guiding symptoms of our materia medica with Dr. Herring. He was author of Drug Relationship, Repertory of Headache, etc. The full name of repertory is Repertory of Herring's Guiding Symptoms of Our Materia Medica. It was published in 1896. It is having total 48 chapters, single volume, and 408 total medicines. Plan and construction. At a macro level, you can divide this repertory into these 5 major components. First, preface. Second, contents, abbreviations of medicine, the chapters or the main part of repertory proper, and index. This is a preface. The preface tells about the arrangement of rubrics. It tells about the distribution of marking or gradations of medicine and acknowledgement of different authors. Starting with the first, it is having a unique feature of gradation of medicine. As you can see over here, you can see some marking in front of a name of a medicine. It is divided into a total 4 or 5 different typography. The first is the medicine denoted with a double thick line, as you can see over here. The medicine which was denoted with a single thick line. The medicines marked with a double simple line. And the medicine which was marked with simple single line or without any line. The meaning of double thick line is the symptoms repeatedly verified. Single vertical thick line denotes symptoms verified by cures. The 2 ordinary vertical line denotes the symptoms more frequently confirmed, or if once confirmed, strictly character with the genius of the remedy. And single ordinary vertical line denotes less occasionally verified symptom. Next symbol is the symbol of hand. It denotes the cross reference. The symbol of pi, which was given over here, you can see it is here. Okay, which denotes the observed on a sick only, is also here the symbol of pi. This is the photograph of a augmented and revised version. You can see the totally the representation of rubric and medicine has been changed in this revised and augmented version. The medicines are denoted with some typography. Okay, then there is also some changes in presentation of rubrics. Theta or the rubrics or some terminology is given in bracket after the rubric represents some pathological or physiological general state observed with a symptom or a rubric. There are also some another symbol, that is a perpendicular dotted line which demarks observation taken from an old school and T, sign of T denotes the toxicological extract. Here you can see the perpendicular dotted line. Now, changes made in augmented and revised edition are: chapters has been rearranged in 33 number, gradations, typography has been changed to a capital bold, capital Roman bold and Roman letters, respectively 4, 3, 2, 1 grades. The rubric arrangement also changed. Rubric presented in a capital bold letters, but it was not repeatedly written with the sub rubrics. Sub rubrics are written in a Roman bold letters. This is a typography. You can observe the capital bold letters. Then Roman bold letters. The hand symbol replaced by a representation of a bracket with a C and cross reference. Cross references you can find with the same rubric in the same chapter or with a different chapter. These are some photographs. You can see the arrangement, different typography. You can see here the cross reference, C, anxiety, restlessness. Here in same chapter you can see some cross reference. Here also C, organic affection. T has been denoted as a bracket in T, dotted line as a underline in the remedy, and pi has been changed to a italics with underline. So here you can see the bracket and symbol of T. Here also the toxicological symptom, anthem tart and bracket in T. Total 408 medicine. Chapters arranged in some alphabetical form. The first chapter of mind and disposition and end with the chapter of drug relationship. Organ wise classification till 34th chapter, and the remaining chapters represent the reactions of the whole body. These are the chapters, photograph taken from a software Homoeopathic classic version. Total 48 chapters till limbs in general. It is following the anatomical scheme. Then the chapters are rest and position, nerve, sleep, time, denotes the general conditions. Each chapter is alphabetical, divided into sections and rubrics sufficient to allow full scope for analysis. So at the start of every chapter, we will find a group of rubrics written in this thing. Okay, here. You can also see here, there is some rubrics given: confusion, dizziness, giddiness. So these are the list of rubrics. You will find only this main rubrics in a chapter, and you are just going to refer this list of rubrics before you are going to search any rubric or subrubrics in this particular chapter. Okay, these are the list of rubrics. Now some special chapters, the rest, position and motion, deals with the general aggravation and amelioration related with the different positions. Time chapter has include different rubrics related with the different time modalities. Temperature and weather includes the rubrics like air, cold, dark, light, seasons, temperature, water, weather, etc. Attacks and periodicity, it contains the rubrics like nature of attack, season and periodicity. Locality and direction include the rubric of different locations and directions of a radiating symptoms. So these are the rubrics. In attacks and periodicity, you will get attacks alternate, autumn, increasing, intermitting, moon phases, periodical, then spring, sudden, summer, or weekly, winter, yearly, etc. In tissues chapter, you will get different rubrics like adipose tissues, bones, cancer, cartilage, decomposition, tumors, tubercles, hypertrophy, inflammation, etc. These are the list of rubrics. You will also have muscles, nutrition, then pyemia, swelling, tubercles. Okay. Touch, passive motion injuries, it contains the rubrics, types of injuries, reactions to touch, etc. And the most important chapter, the stage of life and constitution, which deals with the different rubrics related with the age, children, girls, men, then complexion, constitutions like anemic, asthmatic, habits, occupations, size, temperaments. Okay, so these are the rubrics of chapter stages of life and constitution. It has a main 7 different components or 7 rubrics. You will find first age, complexion, constitution, habit, occupation, size and temperament. And under this all, you will see a different sub rubrics. Like here in occupation, you can see the actors, then auctioneers, the bookworms. Okay, and you also have asthma, minors, nurse, exhausted by long nursing, orators, workers in plaster, cachectic, sailor's asthma, sedentary occupation. Okay, so these are the list of occupation. You have also singers, speakers, then stone masons, students, teachers, washerwoman. And this is the chapter of drug relationship. You will find some explanation of simple terminologies we are going to use in a drug relationship: antidotes, then collateral, compatible, complementary, inimical, etc. And then you will have a list of drug relationship with each and every medicine. Arrangement of rubrics. Rubrics are arranged in a double column. Main rubric in capital bold letters. Every time main word is reprinted with a sub rubric, this is in the original version. Right, left words are used as whole to avoid confusion. Okay, so you can see this is the arrangement of rubric. Augmented in revised edition, the rubrics arranged in a double column, but main rubric is not repeated with a sub rubric. The main rubric is denoted with a simple dash or double dash for a sub rubric to just make some arrangement more easily explainable. This here you can see the double dash with sub rubric. Working method of this repertory is you can form a totality using this 6 different symptoms of type of symptoms. The first, you can use temperament and stages of life and constitution. Next, you can use mind and disposition. Then also you can use physical generals. You can also use complaints with special features. Tissue affinities you can use, and single symptom you can refer to find out your medicine. Merits: repertory in Pu'er's language, vast information based on Herring's guiding symptom, drug relationship chapter, cross references are given, can be used as a reference books. Very important rubrics you can find in clinical examination, like murmurs or respiratory sounds are also given. Demerits: not useful for systematic repertorization. Many rubrics are having single remedy. Arrangement of rubrics are confusing, as the whole sentences are written but arranged alphabetically on the base of main word in symptoms. You can visit some my blog or my website for more information, and also you can write down your comments and suggestions for the same. Thank you.